Well, good afternoon. It's not that much, but not that it makes much difference. It's a bit murky out there. So, I'm going to make my cover for this year's Mission Inspiration. That should just be just about big enough. So I'm going to cut this in half. This is just some packaging I got sent parceling. It's not too thick. It should be sturdy enough. I'm going to grab my lithium. You can never undo this thing. There we go. No, there no. Just gonna chop off the end. Probably can't see what I'm doing this side note. That's okay. And also so that I can get it into the guillotine a bit better. Right. This year I want to do a nice 8x8 journal. Just fancy, nice sort of big square to work on. Rather than the little rectangles I had last year or this year. Move a little bit so I can see where I'm cutting here. I'm going to use this. Lovely thing that I got in my craft box. It's not being cut straight here though. So I'm going to move it over. It's a large surface area to glue down onto. The problem I find with double-sided glue is that it dries and then peels off. So I'll cut this a bit smaller so that I can work with it a little bit more easily. And then we'll use the gel medium. I like that. It's very nice. Beautiful. So I did grab some bits out of the box as well. Bits to use. So look at some of these. Beautiful papers. What do I want to use? I don't know. Nice. Do some of that. Oh, this is the problem when you have a really beautiful background and you don't want to cover it. I have this from a card making kit, and where's that? My scissors are here. Just get rid of the pips. And I popped it out. Let's think. What are we gonna do? Some vintage tram tickets my fiancé gave me. Let's have some of these. Beautiful. And do I want some music tech? Am I gonna rip this or cut it or let's move that to one side for 1 second. Grab the flower again. One of those there, and then this. Okay. something in the middle of there, like this. Yes, it's coming together. Let's start. I'm just gonna want some vintage photo around some edges. So that everything's defined and blends together. If that makes any sense. So each piece is defined, but the whole thing comes together because of the same ink. Yes. Distress that. There we go. Glue it down. I don't think I'm going to do the tickets because they're already properly antiqued. The side there a little bit. And I'm getting gel medium everywhere. This one. This is the shiny one. So I don't know if it's a gel meet the distress ink is gonna stay. But oh well. Right, let's see how good these stickers are. Gonna have to use a pencil. Actually glue it to the frame thingy. Perhaps should have drawn on the back, but never mind. Yes. Nice, very nice. Let's get some glue on here. Or gel medium, I should say. Right, and let's get the old label maker. Buttons, clear with white ink, I don't want that, clear with black ink, clear or black, do I want black? White and black, let's have white and black. How to put the back on properly. Print. And just hope the word inspiration fits inside there. Yes, it does. Excellent. It's all coming together. So we just need to trim. Down a little bit, it fits nicer. This has come together quite quickly, actually. Very pleased with it. Okay. The only thing I don't like is that I've cut that bit wonky. Let's try and it's not much better, but if I keep going, I'm not going to have anything left. There we go. Now then, do I want this still? Just turn that off and pop it there. Yes, I like that. What colour do I want to do it? Do I just want to distress it? I think I want to paint it, actually. Gold? Gold. Let's get some gold paint. So I need to go and get my paint box. Okay, so I've got gold paint. And a sponge. And then I think I'm gonna maybe add a bit of vintage photos to this once it's dry. Maybe. I have Fantage powders, I could have used that. Yeah, that's nicely covered. I think I'll just grab the heat tool and dry that off, and I'll be back in a second. Okay, so that dried rather quickly because the sponge, you can just put a minimal amount of paint on it. let's see how that looks. Darken that down a bit nicely. Let's stick that down. Ooh, gosh. Put big blobs on. Lightly brushing the back and then splodging it. Let's try that. There we go. What I'm thinking is, if we rub around the edges with the vintage photo, I can stay on my hands. But it's all nicely blended and distressed. Okay. Uh, And then what I'm thinking is to bring in the gold. If we grab the sponge again, pop a little bit on, and then just get some gold going on the edges. Oh, very nice. There we go. And I love it. I actually really do love that. I think it's beautiful. This map just totally makes the page, I think. I don't think I want to do anything else to that. I'm just going to let it dry. And then for the back of this, I think I'm just going to pop a sheet of something nice, some nice vintage paper on the back. Just keep it plain. On my last one, I did have a pocket in the cover, but I never used it really, so I don't think I'm going to bother this time. I'll just use a nice piece of paper. Okay, so what I might do is just cut my back piece to size, and then I'll come back and we might decorate that as well. Okay, so we're just going to use the rest of the map at the back. And find my scissors. Down. Will not be wasted. I will use it on something. It's beautiful. I really do like it. It's beautiful. Nice. Anyway, let's start with the top again. And I did realise I hadn't stuck down the metal embellishment in the page to the cover, so I've done that now. Making a mess everywhere with the drawing. little bit. Sorry, I haven't. I wasn't much in that last little bit, have I? Just blue. Kind of got lost in my own little world then. There we go. Very nice. Right. Now I'm going to grab my scissors again. I've lost them again out here. I'll show you all my address. Please don't send me horrible things. I'll steal my identity. Let's see if I can edit it. But you can't see that. Okay. Let's distress the edges again. You know what I could do? Ooh, I've just had a lovely idea. Yes, we'll do that next. How am I gonna do that? Oh yes, I have some clearing, so maybe that will work. Okay. I don't think I'm going to put a lot on the back here. I think this will do. It's the back cover, so we're not gonna see it as often as the front cover. I somehow don't think I cut it straight, but never mind. Oh, I like that sea monster. Can you see that? It's really cool. I haven't noticed that before. Very cool. Now then. Is that. Now I just need to go away and get some supplies and have a little think, because I have a plan. I have a cunning plan. So I'll be right back. I have before me an interesting array of objects gathered. So I'm going to undo this. I am by no means a great jewellery maker, so please excuse me if my methods are a little crude. So this came in the craft box as well. And I did say that I would probably never wear it. Because it's way too chunky for my liking. Could do with a pair of pliers here, but I only have the one. That didn't sound right, did it? Two pairs of pliers. Pair, right. And I need to pinch that so that doesn't fall off there. Somehow. Go from this side, maybe. Oh, this is tricky. Oh, very fiddly. Here we go. Not pinching it. Oh dear. Oh yes, yes, that's it, that's what I wanted. That's quite tight now, that will do. And then I'm going to pop a hole in the corner here. Let's see, I think this, or this. This is the closest colour we have, and I'm going to need three of these. More, actually. Five of those. I can't do it yet. I need to put the back on. I need to put some paper on the back of this. Oh, sorry. So, let's grab out our vintage pads. Do one on the inside. Okay, so that one did grab my attention, so let's have that one. Now then. Now that we can put our eyelets on properly, let's do that. Actually gonna grab, if it's in here. Oh no, it's in this drawer, isn't it? My life easier. Later on I'm gonna use a hole punch. Find the middle. It's about there. And I can't see that mark. Here we go. There we go. Now when I hole punch my pages, I'll just be able to use that punch rather than trying to line up with the single punch that I have moved and this one. Memory keeper's punch. So we have our eyelets that hopefully should fit still, yeah. Let me think which one do I want it on. That one. I guess that one and that one. I think. Let's try it. One there again. Eek, messy. And another one here. Now I do want a hole up here. Corner, I think. Need to be pretty close to the corner because the loop is not huge. I'll pop that in there and set it. There's a bird singing away out there, it's lovely. And then I'm going to grab this and we're going to pop this through. Oh no! Lost my loop. Amazingly, I have found it. Didn't think I would, but I have. We're going to grab that through there. Ah! Stop dropping it. Maybe I should work over the table, and then if I do drop it, won't go anywhere. This is going to be tricky. I don't think the loop is going to be quite big enough, to be honest. Now then. Do I have any? Oh yeah, I'm gonna want big loops, I think. 1, 2. Now then. I'm gonna use really big loops for this one. I may buy some slightly smaller ones eventually. But, yeah. Pages might get nice and chunky, so we've got some nice big loops. Now then, I'm going to do the same on the back. Find some paper. And I will be back once I've put it together. So, I'm an absolute blithering idiot. Can you see what I've done there? I've put them on the wrong side. So, I'm going to put some more on. And then I'm thinking of having some sort of ribbons to tie the journal shut on that side. I haven't got any elastic, I don't think. Can't believe I did that. But yeah. I did. So I'm going to leave it at that. I'm not going to do any of the pages because I want to see how I feel each month. I might reuse craft card, scrapbook paper, mixed media paper. You know, never know what I'm going to use. So I'm going to leave that and do it as needed. So I hope you enjoyed watching this video. And you will join us this year for the Mission Inspiration. Gonna be great, I think. This year was so much fun. Yeah, so I don't know if I mentioned in this section. I'm not going to cut the pages yet because I might use different types of pages. I think I've already said this. So I'll just cut them as and when needed. So, yeah, thank you for watching. I've enjoyed your company. And I'll see you again soon. Bye, guys.